How many tons of steel and concrete that come down, they drop 15 feet in a nanosecond, then there's an acceleration, they accelerate even more when they hit the next floor because they, one floor is moving at this huge velocity, the other floor is standing still, then that floor goes and the next floor goes because it's,
Fellas, they're flagging me because we're way behind and we have to take a break. Mike, I appreciate it very much. You did a good job.
Okay.
All right. I appreciate it. And Richard Gage, you're doing a good job. And we have lots of people that want to talk with you. We'll take a break. We'll be back. I'm Pat Desmaris, in for Dan Ray. We're talking with Richard Gage. He's the founder, architects, and engineers for 911 Truth. And it's your opportunity to ask him a question about the things he's saying this evening. We'll be back. WBZ News Radio, 1030.
Nightside. Dan Ray, WBZ News Radio, 1030. Nightside with Dan Ray. Be a part of the show. Call 617-254-1030.
Richard Gage is my guest, founder, architects of engineers for 911 Truth. What brought down truly the Twin Towers? What brought down building number 7? And Richard is making a case that some type of explosive devices had to have brought them down because of the way they were brought down. Richard, correct me if I'm wrong, but frankly, if there weren't some sort of help to bring those buildings down, a controlled blast, if you will, they would have just sort of toppled over, correct? You there, Richard? Did we lose him?
Extremely redundant, robust structures, and our 40 structural engineers that are signed on to our petition demanding a new investigation would disagree with our previous caller, Mike, that a building can fall straight down through the 40,000 tons of steel as if it weren't even there. The laws of physics are such that the building has to slow down if it's going to crush steel on the way down, but it did not. And NIST acknowledges that it did not, but they do not acknowledge the implications of a free-falling structure.
Let's go to Mike, who's out in California. And Mike, good evening. You're on WBZ in Boston.
Thank you, Pat. It's really interesting to hear you talking with Mr. Gage. And a few days ago, I was reading an article in the Washington Times that was referring to explosive evidence, much as you're discussing tonight. And at the end of the article, it described that Mr. Gage was suggesting that if citizens or people like Mr. Gage himself as an architect were to submit this evidence that he has to a public official, let's say a judge or a district attorney or an attorney general, that they would be compelled to forward this on to the appropriate authorities, and if they did not, it would be misprision of treason. And I wonder if Mr. Gage has made any attempt to submit such evidence to any grand jury or to any judicial officer in the government.
Richard?
Yes, we've provided our petition and evidence to every congressman and 20 or 30 of them personally. We went to their offices. And by the way, your listeners can download this evidence from our website, which is ae911truth.org. That stands for Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth. And it can be downloaded, and the DVD is available there to watch also. So I would encourage everybody to familiarize yourselves more with this evidence. And I completely agree with the caller that providing this evidence, which is really evidence of treason if you think about it, because I agree with Pat that this is obviously some sort of an inside operation. We just don't know who exactly is responsible, but it amounts to treason nonetheless. So we're asking everybody to submit it to their judge so it can go through the proper channels on the way up.
All right, Mike, thanks so much. I want to grab some more of these calls. We're short for time. Rich is in a car. Rich, hi, you're on WBZ. You're on with Richard Gage.
Yeah, hi, Richard. Hi, Pat.
Hi.
My question is, do you honestly feel that the government, our government, had a lot to do with this and they're covering it up? And the reason being is, like you said, for thousands of people that are missing. You have, or you think that they could have had something to do with this too?
I missed the last one. Who could have something to do with it too?
The 1,000 people that haven't been accounted for.
Oh, well, we're working for the family members right now. We have the Jersey Girls signed on to our website. Numerous family members are asking of us to get at the truth of the death of their loved ones, and only that truth will heal these family members. And there was obviously some sort of cover-up.
Right.
This has proven that to us.
See,
that's why we're calling for a federal grand jury investigation of Sean Thunder, the lead investigator of NISP, and his co-project leader, John Gross.
Okay, because when all this happened, I had my suspicions, you know. I had to wait a minute. And I always felt uncomfortable with that, you know, like, how is this possible, you know, that the two buildings are just going to collapse, you know? And I was telling my wife about it, and she goes, "You're crazy." I said, "You know what? I got a feeling that our own government has something to do with this." And she said, "I was crazy, you know?" But then she asked me, "Well, why do you feel that way?" I said, "Well, because I'm mixed military, you know, and I saw a lot of things, you know, that our government was involved in, you know, and so on, you know, and I was told not to talk about it, you know, and so on, you know." And it's like Timothy McVeigh in the Oklahoma City bombing, you know, and even in that case, you know, I had my suspicions on that, whether or not he was working for the intelligence, what he said, or for the government at one time. You know, honestly, you know, people might not believe it, but I honestly believe that something was there, you know.
Fair enough, Rich. I apologize for cutting it short, but we're short for time. We have a lot of people waiting. Richard, I have to break, but do you offer any theories to the audience and to me about the other two planes, one that hit the Pentagon and one that was brought down somewhere in Pennsylvania in a field, presumably by the passengers who decided to take matters into their own hands?
What we know about the Pentagon is that there were dozens and dozens of cameras that would have shown us what did or didn't hit the Pentagon. And the fact that they haven't been released, except for these five very controversial frames, is proof that there is a cover-up.
What's controversial about the five frames?
Well, some people claim that they see an airplane. Others claim they see something else. What should have been released is the videos from the hotel and the gas station and the Pentagon, the first two being confiscated within 5 or 10 minutes of the actual crash by the FBI.
Okay, fair enough. Richard Gage joins us. Lots of people waiting to talk to Richard, and we'll make this a quick break, and we'll come right back. Pat Desmaris in for Dan Ray on News Radio 1030 WBZ.
Nightside. Dan Ray, WBZ News Radio 1030. Local or national, the issues that matter most. Nightside with Dan Ray, WBZ News Radio 1030.
Are you suspicious about September 11th? Do you wonder if perhaps maybe we don't know everything? Do you think maybe our government had something to do with it? Founder of Architects and Engineers for 911 Truth, Richard Gage, is our guest this hour. Pat's in Worcester. Pat, you're on with Richard. Pat, you still there?
Yes.
Hi, you're on with Richard Gage.
Hi. I had a theory from the beginning, right after it happened, because I was telling my husband it looked like it imploded. Everything imploded, and I was saying that 7 years before that, when they bombed the basement of the buildings, that they had 7 years to have the cleaning people or whatever go through the whole building and plant different devices so that it would implode when it was hit.
Many people do ask, well, how could somebody have gotten explosives in there? After all, there's tens of thousands of occupants. They would have seen something. But the interesting thing is, if you had access to the core elevator shafts, you would have access to the core columns and beams in the building and could plant these explosives without being seen by the occupants. And it turns out, in fact, that we had the largest elevator modernization in history going on in those two buildings the 9 months prior to 9/11. Ace Elevator had the contract, and so we want an investigation of them, as well as the security company, Securicom and Stratasec.
All right.
He was on the board of directors of those companies.
Pat, I apologize. We're out of time. My apologies to all the other callers. We're just out of time. Richard Gage, I'll give you this. You're well-spoken. You are a very reasonable man. Obviously, an educated fellow. So you have at least convinced me to continue to be open-minded about this. You haven't, for whatever it's worth to you, you haven't convinced me yet that it was anything but what I think that it was, but...
Would you be willing to watch the DVD, Pat?
I would.
All right. You can find it at ae911truth.org.
Richard Gage, it was a pleasure. I hope we talk again.
All right, sir.
Yeah, bye-bye. Steve Lavelli is up next. I have issues with Steve Lavelli. He's pro-simple majority. I don't like that. I'll be back tomorrow night. The news is next on WBZ. You got to watch that, Lavelli.